Right. Good evening, everyone. In last class, we are discussing about relational operators. I hope you understand. All people understand relational operators, and I hope you practiced. And now, in today's class, let us try to understand equality operators. Now, again, reminding on each operator, we are understanding these are the 10 points. Can you please try to recollect? These are the 10 points. Try to apply these 10 points on equality operators. Tell me, how many operators and what are they? As part of equality operators, we have two operators, double equal to operator, not equal to operator. What are the use of those operators? Equality operators are used for comparing two values or two objects. Did you listen my statement? Equality operators are used for comparing two values or two objects. We completed assignment operator, arithmetic operators, increment decrement operators, relational operators, compound assignment operators. While discussing other operators, I didn't use the word called object. In assignment operator, we have object. If you want to store object reference in one destination variable, we use assignment operator. Assignment operator and equality operators. These two operators can be used on both values and objects. Arithmetic operators, increment decrementing operators, relational operators, compound assignment operators, you cannot use on objects. Okay, you can only use on primitive values, mathematical values. So equality operator and assignment operator, you are allowed to apply on all data types. All data types available in Java, you can apply, but should not be incompatible. So the operands must be compatible. Okay, let me try to apply once again all the points. Under equality operator, we have two operators. They are double equal to, not equal to. Equality operators are used for comparing two values or two objects, either they are equal or not equal. So equality operators are binary operators. It accepts two operands. Okay, the allowed operands are can be literals, can be variables, can be expression, can be method call. Okay, the method call must be non-void method call. Type of operands allowed are, all types are allowed. Two Boolean data types, two shorts, two int, two longs, two floats, two doubles, two characters, two Booleans. You can also compare two Booleans, two strings, two array objects, two class objects. But the two operands must be compatible to each other. Okay, next. Now when we use equality operator or not equal to operator, what is the result type coming from this equality operator? Boolean, because they are comparing now. Okay, they are comparing. After comparing, it should tell true or false. Okay, Boolean operator is generated. Next, if I use this expression in the program, where can I use? Double equal to operator, not equal to operator are not meant for storing values. They are meant for only generate the result and returning the result to us. Are you catching my point? Generating result and returning result. So you cannot use double equal to operator, not equal to operator expression as a single statement like increment decrement operator. Okay, the only two operators you can use as a single statement are number one assignment operator or number two equal increment and decrement operator. Except these two operators, you cannot use any other operator as a single statement. So you are allowed to use equality operators expression either as a variable assignment or a method call, or as a method argument, or as a method return value, and also add what as a if condition and a loop condition, because it's generating Boolean value. Okay, yesterday points, if you practice, today I'm talking will usually you can visualize. Okay, where they are allowed to use variable assignment, method argument, method return type, and as a operand, expression operand also allowed, and if condition and loop condition. If you want to assign equality operator expression to a variable, the variable type, method parameter type, method return type, operand type must be Boolean. Where Boolean is allowed, there only equality operator is allowed. Okay, next operator's precedence, double equal to operator, not equal to operator having same precedence. There is no difference. And associativity, left to right order. Okay, first left operand executed, then a right operand executed, then compared and result generated. Next, when we use operator with combination with other operators, equality operator is having precedence after relational operator. Okay, first prefix, postfix, unary operators all are executed, then arithmetic operator multiplicative, then arithmetic operator additive, then shift operator, then relational. After all these five operators execution completed, then equality operators got a chance to execute. Is it clear my point? Right. So these are all the points, 9 points related to equality operator, common points. Then we need to test all these points in a sample program, and inter equations and OCA bits we need to practice. All are ready for testing a program? Tell me, I want to develop a program to find the given number duplicate or not. Which operator I must use? I want to find a number is duplicate or not. I'm taking array. Let's say I'm taking array. Okay, I'm taking one array. In that array, I am storing all integers. In this array, I want to store only unique values. I don't want to store duplicate values. Then what I should use, tell me? I must use comparison. Now, the second value you are storing in the array, you must compare second value with the first value. Okay, if second value not equal to first value, then store. If it is the same, don't store. Okay, then third value coming. Third value you must compare with the first value, second value. If it is unique, store. Otherwise, don't store. Okay. I want to store only unique objects. Then I must use what? Equality operator. Okay. Next, while storing, I want to sort the values. I want to store in ascending order or descending order. Sorting order I want to store. Then you must use equality operators. Okay. Sorry. Then you must use relational operators. Less than, greater than. Okay. If you want to store in ascending order or descending order, you must find which is big, which is small. For that, you must use less than, greater than. If you wanted to stop duplicates, and I want to store ascending order, descending order, sorting order, then you must use less than or equals to or greater than or equals to combination. Okay, na? Again, repeating, unique, duplicate, no need to worry. You pass any value, no problem. I wanted to store, but I want to store in sorting order. Then use relational operator less than, greater than. I wanted to store only unique values, duplicates I don't want. Then compare by using double equal to, not equal to operators. I want to store only unique objects in ascending order. Then you must use less than or equals to, greater than or equals to operators you must use. Then based on this knowledge, in an arrays chapter, I will develop the program. Are you catching my point? Currently in operators chapter, by using operators, you cannot develop big programs because operators are used for performing calculations, validations. To perform calculations and validations, I need one scenario. To develop that scenario, first of all, you should have a knowledge on control flow statements, if condition, okay, loops, okay, and then arrays. If you know operators, control flow statements, and then arrays chapter, then we can go for big applications development. That's why this unit number 3 is what? Logical programming. First operators, then control flow statements, then arrays completed after, then we are going for algorithms and 100 plus, you know, logical programs development with all the enhancements we are learning. So some people are maybe in a feeling that Sari is teaching all the programs. I mean, Sari is teaching all the points, but only bits are telling, but programs not developing. If you want to develop programs, you should have a clarity, first of all, understanding on control flow statements, arrays, combination of operators, okay, combination of data types, operators, control flow statements, arrays. These four topics combination only you can develop applications. Data types completed, then operators after completed, control flow statements completed, arrays completed, then only you can develop programs. Number-based programs, character-based programs, pattern-based programs, array-based programs, searching, sorting algorithms, all you can develop. I'm just giving an idea which operator in which situation is coming. Then slowly you are going to get application development easily, knowledge. Is it clear? Tell me,
when you are learning cycle, if you decided to learn cycle, can you learn cycle first day itself? Is it possible to ride cycle? Can you go for racing with your friends in first day cycle itself? Is my point understand? What you do? First you learn how to use a pedal, how to use a pedal to balance your body, how to use a brake, how to use a bell, how to use handle, how to balance cycle. Step by step you are going, and finally one day, once you have confidence, okay, by knowing all the parts of the cycle, how to manage, then you are calling your friend, era, before I learn cycle you insult me, kamra, let me see your pratapam na pratapam, come on. So first you are getting full clarity on, okay, first you are getting full clarity on concept, each operator, how to work, okay, and what are the possible entry questions can come from that operators, then we will try to use this operator in the application development. Okay, now I'm going for equality operator. Now tell me, I have a variable A, I have a variable B, I have a variable C, yesterday variables only. A double equal to B. Allowed? Allowed. A not equal to B, allowed? Allowed. Tell me, what is the output of A double equal to B? A value 10, B value 20. A double equal to B, true. True or false? Sorry, false. A double equal to B, false. Because 10 is not equal to B. A not equal to B, true or false? A not equal to B, 10 not equal to B, yes, true. Control 1, compile. Control 2, true, false. Okay, false, true. Then next, B double equal to C, B not equal to C. 20 equal to C, yes, true. 20 not equal to C, false. True, false. Next, if I place B and C in single quote, what is comparing? B and C, if I place in single quote, what is comparing? B and C, if you place in single quote, it's comparing B value, C value, or B itself. B itself is compared. Okay, B equal to C? No, false. B not equal to C? Yes, true. False, true you will get. Okay, next. Can I use true as an operand? True equal to true? True equal to true? Yeah, correct. True. False equal to false? Yeah, false. True, true. Will you get output true? True. Look at that. True, true. Next. Simple. Don't confuse. Okay. Simple. Ask question. Just questions. True equal to false? No. True not equal to false? Yes. False, true is answer. False, true. False, true. All are you following? Just I am trying to verify double equal to operator functionality. Tell me, numeric data, on numeric data it is allowed, character data it is allowed, boolean data it is allowed. Tell me, can I use with string objects double equal to double quotes A, double equal to double quotes A? Yes. Now tell me here what happened. Double quotes A, string object, double quotes A, string object. Hey, when you compare objects, double equal to operator compares data of the object or reference of the object. Primitive data types, if you take, no confusion. But if you take reference data types, there is a confusion. Observe. Primitive data types directly value compared. Value equal to value compare. Very important point. If you compare objects, first object equal to second object, there is a confusion. What is that? It is the reference 10-10. It is the reference 20-20. Now double equal to operator by default compares two objects with a reference, not with data. Carefully listen, very important point. Double equal to operator by default compares two objects by using reference, not by using data. Tell me now, double quotes A, it is a string object, na? Double quotes A, it's a one object, 10, 10. Tell me now, double quotes A second time when you repeat, new object is not created. The same object will be used. Double quotes A here also 10, 10. Here also 10, 10 only substituted. It is a specialty of string object. It comes under a concept called string pooling. It comes under a concept called string pooling. If string literally is repeated, new object is not created, same object is substituted every time. It's a very important point, just accept and remember. Then, now tell me, next statement. New string of double quotes A. Now, new keyword must create another new object, right? New keyword always create new object. New object created with the data A. Another new keyword means another new object created. Pakka new object created. Literal wise, new object not created. But a new keyword wise always creates new object. Tell me, here output is true. Here output is false. Sir, data same now, sir. That's what I'm telling you. Double equal to operator by default compare two objects by using what? Reference, not by using data. Okay, this reference and this object reference is not equal. So we're getting what? False. Okay, next. If I compare new string of double quotes A, another new object is created with reference what? 40, 40. Now A. And next double quotes A, same old object 10, 10 return. 40, 40 equal to 10, 10. No, then it returns what? False. Everyone understand? Tell me what the use of double equal to operator, not equal to operator. They're used for comparing primitive values and objects to know whether they are equal or not. Primitive values are compared by their values only, whereas objects are compared by using reference, not by using data. The statement, if you don't accept and remember, you will face lot of problems in coming classes and you'll miss all the questions and you'll develop wrong applications. Did you all accept it? Come on. All you accepted? Can you please reply? Accepted? Now you must ask me question. Okay, sir. But I'm taking two student objects, sir. Student number and student name. Second student object also there. Student number, student name. Its reference is 10, 10. Its reference is 20, 20, sir. I want to compare student objects according to real life. I need to compare two objects by using data. How can I compare, sir? I want to compare objects. Okay. Reference only by default compared by using double equal to operator. I want to compare two objects by using data. What should I do? Instance of operator to know this is an object of student class. Is this an object is student class type or not? If you want to know type comparison, then you go for instance of operator. Reference comparison, you should use a double equal to operator. Data comparison, you must use method equals. You must write logic, na? If you want to compare objects using data, you must write logic. S1 dot SNO equal to S1 dot SNO, right? You need to write some logic. To write the logic, now tell me, I need to define some method. Now finally try to answer once again all points. Point number one, I want to compare two primitive values. I have only one approach, that is double equal to operator. Next, I want to compare two objects. Now we have two options. We have either double equal to operator there, and also we have a predefined method called equals method. Okay, then what is the difference between double equal to operator equals method? Double equal to operator is used for comparing both primitive values and objects. Okay, equals method can compare only objects. This is the first point you should remember. First point, okay? Second point, double equal to operator compares two objects always by using reference. Okay, equals method compares two objects by using, come on, expecting all the people to fill in the blank, okay, by using dash. fill the gap by using come on equals method compares two objects by using wonderful everyone is telling by using data are bujji if you want to compare objects by using data logic must write na what I told equals method is a predefined method who has defined Sun Microsystem defined how Sun Microsystem knows your student class comparison logic your employee class comparison logic your bank account class comparison logic come on think it's very important point equals method implementation given by Sun Microsystem is compared objects by using reference only okay or data reference or data compares two objects by using reference or data based on its implementation okay based on its implementation means logic okay very important by default equals method also fill the gap equals method also compares two objects by using what is the common logic of all class objects reference by using reference only now tell me if you want to compare two objects by using their data what to do tell me sir you are feeling hungry sir by default your mother prepared the food in the home and your mother only sitting and eating the food you feeling hungry then who should eat the food you should eat the food na your father feeling hungry your father should eat right your brother feeling hungry your brother should eat right your sister feeling hungry your sister should eat oh my god nowadays these many children are there in a home no only one children maximum two no okay assume your family is a big family okay very well understand now finally try to answer whoever feeling hungry that person should eat that means if your class objects want to compare with data then what to do you must override means you must define equals method in our class we must override equals method in our class what our class student or employee or bank account whatever the classes you want in those classes you must override very important confusion point hey come again very important confusion point is very much confusion and very important interviewer expecting this a point explanation interviewer definitely ask a question what is the difference between equals method and double equal to operator this question is compulsory you have to start with the first statement double equal to operator used for comparing two primitive values and also used for comparing two objects whereas equals method can compare only objects double equal to operator by default always compare two objects by using reference whereas equals method can compare two objects equals method compare two objects either by using reference or by using data based on our implementation by default equals method compares two objects by using reference only tell me sir if in my class equals method is not available then double equal to operator comparison equals method comparison both are same only na if you override equals method in your class then equals method double equal to operator story will be different can you please take screenshot of this slide I'm going to write code for this now we are going to test it so whenever you are working with double equal to operator immediately in your mind equals method also should flash okay tell me here two objects created or one object created in a string two objects created or one object created only one object created in this statement two objects created or one object created two different objects created with same data now tell me I want to compare two strings by using data. I must use what? Double equal to operator or equals method? Chalo chalo, fast. Reply fast. Quick. Be fast. Today we need to complete this topic. Equals method topic, double equal to operator, both we need to complete. It's a big topic. 200 lines of code is there. 240 lines of code is there. You need to fast. System.out.println double equal to A equals of double equal to A if you write. Then don't answer fast. By reading this point, remember this point. Always you have to produce this point only for all my questions. Tell me, if I use equals method to compare these two strings, will you get true or false? 100% you will get true. Why? Because this is a two different objects, are same object. Literal, same object, okay? One object only created, one object comparison, 100% you will get true, no doubt in that. Because reference-wise, data-wise, same object. Now the confusion. Tell me, here will you get true or false? Come on. Here you will get true or false. New string of double quotes, say it is one object with one reference, it is another object with a new reference, okay? Then tell me, equals method I am using to compare two objects, then will you get true or false? Depends. Come on. Will you get output true or false or depends? Chalo. True or false or depends? Depends, Nana. Why? If equals method is overridden in, you call using which class object? String class. If equals method is overridden in a string class, then it returns what value? True. Data comparison. If equals method not overridden, it returns what? False. Reference comparison. Check. Compile, execute. What you are getting answer? True. What does it mean? In a string class, equals method is overridden by Sun Microsystem to compare two string objects by using data. So come to the point now. Tell me, if you want to compare two string class objects by using reference, you must use? If you want to compare two string objects by using reference, you must use double equal to operator. If you want to compare two string objects by using data, you must use equals method. Okay, remember this point, very important. And tell me, here I'm going to write some statement. New string of double quotes A dot equals of double quotes A. Tell me, it returns a true or false? Equals method is overridden in string class. If it is overridden in string class, it compare two string objects by using their data. This is a different string object data A. This is another string object data A. So we'll get output true. Wonderful. Now there is another special point with the string class. What's the special point? If you compare two string objects with different case, Java is case sensitive, na? Identifier chapter, Java is a case sensitive. What the meaning of case sensitive? Small a not equal to capital A. Now, data is the same, but case is different. So equals method returns false. Hello? I don't want to consider case. Without considering case, I wanted to compare. Then what I should use? Equals ignore case method. Okay, this equals ignore case method specially defined in string class. It is not common to all class objects. Equals method and double equal to operator are common to all classes objects, but equals ignore case method specially defined for a string class only. Okay, in a string class, it is specially defined to compare two objects by using data without considering case. Now look at that. Now we'll get output true here because data is the same, case is not considered. Am I confusing you? All the people comfortable up to now? All the people comfortable? No confusion? Shall we try to recollect quickly all points what we discussed? Point number one. Come on, let's try to quickly revise all points what we discussed up to now. Now tell me. we are trying to understand which operators today? Equality operators. Along with equality operators, we are also trying to understand predefined methods, equals method, equals ignore case method. Equality operators, how many operators are there? Two. Double equal, what are they? Double equal to operator, not equal to operator. What the use of those operators? Double equal to operator, not equal to operator, used for comparing two primitive values or two objects. Then double equal to operator compare two objects by using reference. If you want to compare two objects by using their data, I must use equals method. All people are under wrong impression that equals method always compare two objects by using data. That is a wrong statement. Okay, by default equals method doesn't compare two objects by using data. It also compare two objects by using reference only. If you want to compare two objects by using data, by using equals method, you must override equals method in your class. If you want to compare two objects of student class by using data, in a student class, you must override equals method. Why I'm using the word called override? Equals method is a predefined method available in java.lang.object class. In a java.lang.object class, already it is defined to compare two objects by using reference. Now you are changing the superclass logic in subclass student. That's why we call it as override. If you create method first time, we call define. If you are already defined method of superclass, you are changing the logic in subclass, then we call it as override. Everyone understand? Then it is what type of operator? Binary operator. What operands are allowed? All four types allowed. What type of operands are allowed? Every data type is allowed. Where we are allowed to use as a variable assignment or method argument or if condition argument or loop argument. Okay, these are all the points you can test. Okay, as relational operators we tested, you test. But today my concentration is on equality operator special points. I'm not going to repeat relational operator same test cases in double equal to operator. You try in your system. Now I'm trying to test double equal to operator and equals method cases because this is very important from interview point of view. Now I want to give you one small test case. Can you please tell me double equal to operator will use or equals method will use or equals ignore case method will use? Please try to take the decision and tell me. Are you ready? I am developing login form here. Okay. Now if you take login form, I'm taking flipkart.com. In flipkart.com, we have login page na. Login, 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 login. Now this is a login form. Here I have my username, mobile number, something I'm giving, Java, Hare Krishna. Okay. I have registered with Java, Hare Krishna, all lowercase. Gmail.com. Okay. With my email, I have registered Java, Hare Krishna, @gmail.com. Already I have registered. Now I am logging in with all capital letters, Java, Hare Krishna, @gmail.com. Is it allowed? Everyone, think and tell me, is it allowed or not? Is it allowed or not? It is allowed, no problem. It is allowed. You try today. You take your Gmail account, Facebook account, or any account. Username is not case sensitive. Okay, na? Point number one, username is not case sensitive. Password is case sensitive. In which case you have entered password, in the same case you should now enter while logging in. Okay, fine. Here I have already, this is my database. In a database already we have login table. In login table already I have username. Now this username and password collected by the browser going to database. Now in database JDBC program trying to verify the username password available or not. Tell me. Here background comparison purpose, you have three options: double equal to operator, equals method, equals ignore case method. What we must use among the three? Click on raise button and confirm. Click on raise button and confirm what I should use among the three. Double equal to operator you must not use, because if you use a double equal to operator, this object reference 1010 is compared with already available object 2020 or whatever. You don't want to compare with reference. You want to compare with data. So you must use either equals method or equals ignore case method. Okay. Now equals method is also not suitable here because you want to compare with the content by ignoring the content, by ignoring the case. Here I have in lower case and here coming upper case. I want to ignore the case of the characters. That's why you must use equals ignore case. I hope you all got the test case. We will develop that code. Don't worry. Okay. First you try to accept the test case and we will develop that code in the coming classes. Now tell me now, once again, I'm asking question, is equals ignore case method or equals method will always compare objects by using content or string objects by using content? Come on. Equals method compare which objects always by using content? String objects. I'm writing string builder SB1 equal to new string builder. It is also predefined class, double quotes here. This class is also predefined class, okay? String builder SB2 equal to new string builder of double quotes here. Now I am writing here system.out.println. I am writing SB1 double equal to SB2. I have written. Will you get a true or false? Come on. Will you get a true or false? Here we'll get a true or false. SB1 double equal to SB2. Will you get a true or false? We will get false. Why? Double equal to operator compare two objects by using reference. Now the dangerous statement. SB1 dot equals of SB1 dot equals of SB2. Can I write or wrong? Yes, I can write. Because equals method is available common to all classes, all class objects in java.lang.objectClass. Okay, this is java.lang.objectClass. Okay, in this class we have equals method defined by Sun Microsystem. This method, this class is the super class of all classes. Okay, string class, string builder class, our class A, our class student, for all classes, okay, java.lang.objectClass is super class. Then whatever the variables methods available in super class, all are inherited to subclass. So you can call equals method by using string object, string builder object, A class object, student class object, anything you can use to call. Then now tell me, here we will get a true or false. Look at that, string buffer object data is A. String builder object data is A. Second string builder object data is also A. What will you get? True or false? Everyone should reply. All people are telling true. Okay. All people are telling true. So still you are using your brain only. You didn't accept the points I have given. What the point I have given? Equals method compares two objects by using either reference or by using data depending on implementation given in that class. If equals method not overridden, you will get reference comparison. If equals method overridden in that class, data comparison. String builder class is a predefined class, not your class. Then how dare you to say, you must question me, sir, equals method overridden or not overridden? You must inquire it first. You must first know equals method overridden or not. If overridden, then you must ask me, yes, true will come, sir. If not overridden, false. When you don't know, you must give both options to me. Maybe true, maybe false, depending on overriding. Come on, thinking capacity, understanding capacity, analyzation capacity you must bring. There is a wrong thought in all people's mind. Equals method by default compare two objects by using data. That is a wrong statement. Remove it from your mind depending on implementation. Maybe reference, maybe data. Equals method not overridden string builder class. That's why it is comparing two objects by using what? reference. Shall I give one more question? This time will you correctly answer? Now look at here. I am taking a class called integer io1 equal to new integer of 50. Next, I am writing integer io2 equal to new integer of 50. I created one object or two different objects? I created two different referenced objects. Then I am comparing two objects by using double equal to operator io1, io2. Tell me, will you get a true or false? Will you get a true or false? 100% will get false because there are two different referenced objects. Double equal to operator compare objects by using reference. Look at there. We got one note. Is it an error? It's a note, not error. We are using some deprecated API. It is telling that. Don't worry. In wrapper classes chapter, we will discuss why, what the meaning of deprecated, how it is deprecated and all. Okay. All right. Next. Now it's not error. It's just a note. I'm just ignoring. Run. We're getting output what? False. We're getting output false. All are you ready with your answers? All are you ready with your answers? Before asking question, you should be ready with your answer, right? What is that? Next, I'm going to test with equals method. Dot equals of io2. Bola. What your answer will get? True or false? Maybe true, maybe false, depending on overriding. True or false? Maybe true or maybe false. Depending on overriding. If equals method overridden, then you will get true. If not over, you'll get false. Let me see now. Control 1 compile. Note coming, just ignore. Control 2. What you got? True. What does it mean? What do you mean that? What is the meaning of this output true? Equals method is overridden in integer class. Is it clear? Simple topic, na? Now one student asked the question. Sir, how do I know equals method overridden in those classes or not? Experience. Okay, day by day going on. By the time core Java completed, you will have everything you will know. These are the predefined classes, na? Predefined classes you will learn as part of volume. Predefined classes you will learn as part of volume 2, right? As part of volume 2 you will learn here under Java API IDEs. There you will get the concept. Okay, at this minute just remember, I will give you one conclusion. What is that? In a string class and in all wrapper classes, integer, byte, short, integer, long, float, double, char, boolean, in a string class and in all wrapper classes, equals method is overridden to compare objects by using content. In a string buffer class and string builder class, there is another class called string buffer. In a string buffer class and string builder class, equals method is not overridden. Hence, when you call equals method, it compares two objects by using reference. Can I hope you got some idea now? Shall I ask one more question? Are you ready? Can I call equals ignore case method? Can I call sb1 dot equals ignore case method? Can I call? Yes, sir. Can I call sb1 dot equals ignore case method? Ayyo. Equals ignore case method is specially defined in string class. I told you, na? Equals method double equal to operator common to all classes. But equals ignore case method is specially defined for string class, in a string class only. If you call this method by using other class objects, compiler slap you. Cannot find symbol method equals ignore case in a string builder class. Okay, variable sb1 of type string builder. Okay, now at least know correctly answer. I am trying to write the statement like this. IO1 dot equals ignore case. IO1 dot equals ignore case. Now tell me, is it compiled or not compiled? Not compiled. Okay, because equals ignore case method specially defined in string class only. Can I hope all the people are comfortable, settled with your mind? Double equal to operator, not equal to operator, equals method, equals ignore case method. Is your mind settled with this concept? Shyam Kumar, are you asking me question or confirming the point? Why string builder in string builder class over equals method is not overridden? You are asking question, huh? Repeat that point. What should I repeat that point? You only told, not overridden. If overridden, you would get true here, right? Because not overridden, that's why you are getting false. Why I should repeat? Now, listen. Now I'm giving another case. These are the predefined cases. Now I'm giving another case. Carefully think and tell me. I have defined one class called A, our own class. Okay? I have defined my own class called A. I created two objects. A, A1 equal to new A with object data 5. A, A2 equal to new A with object data 5. Tell me, this object reference is different from second object, but the data is same. Now, I have called the statements like this. Bolo, what happened? Here, will you get a true or false? Double equal to operator equals method. Both I want you answer at a time. Double equal to operator equals method. Both at a time you must tell. Madhuri, I given a class A to you. Why you are telling depending on? Already shown in front of you, na? Predefined classes depending because you don't know. But class A there in front of you. Confirm. Double equal to operator compare two objects based on reference. A1 reference, A2 reference is different. So, double equal to operator returns true or false? False. Double equal to operator return false. Look at the output coming false. Simple point, bhaiya. Why you people are confusing? I don't know. Okay, stop using your brain. It will be clear. False. And tell me, equals method is equals method available in class A? Is equals method available in class A? No. If not available, where it is executed? From which class it is executed? From java.lang.object class. In java.lang.object class, equals method is comparing two objects by using dash. Come on, reply. By reference. What the reference of A1 different from A2? Then what is the output you get? True or false? False. output is false, false. I told you, na, if equals method not overridden in our class, if equals method is not overridden in our class, by default, both objects are compared by using reference, right? Accepted? Ah, still confused? Still confusion? Ah, should I type every point? Already typed. Already typed. Already you taken screenshot. Again you forgot, my dear Gajini. That's why you are a brand ambassador of Gajini. Already I typed. Already have seen. If equals method not overridden, you will get false because reference comparison. Already explained with string buffer, string builder, integer class, string class. Now again I taken my own class. Again confusion started. Now tell me, is this statement, at least will you tell, will you get a true or false? False, I will get. Will you get false? Are equals ignore case method? You call by using A1, na? You call equals ignore case method by using which object? A1. In A1 class, equals ignore case method is available. When you call a method, compiler software searching for this method definition in A1 class. What is A1 class? A. In A class, equals ignore case method available? No. Checking in super class. In super class object. In object class, equals ignore case method is available? No. Then here what happened? Compiler will throw error. Already told you, again you forgot. Equals ignore case method you can call only by using string object. Before a dot, string object must be there. If you use any other class object, compiler throw error. Already shown you two cases. Third case I have was perfect brand ambassador of Gajini. Hence proved, eh? That's why Gajini movie is a super bumper hit in our industry, in all industry in India. Just now I shown you, right? All people are giving wrong answers. Shall I ask more questions? More questions. No, crying? More questions and getting fear? Devesh Pandey, equals method is overridden in integer class, but not in A class. I am asking equals method calling with A1.x or A1? A1. In A1 class is what? A class. In A class, equals method not available. Shall I ask some more questions? Your mind is able to receive the points. Can you please try to quickly tell me all points we discussed again? Point number one, double equal to operator meant for comparing. Two, I'm writing only shortcuts. Meant of double equal to operator meant for comparing two primitive values or objects. Double equal to operator compares two primitive values by using their primitive variables by using their values and compares two objects by using their by using their reference. Third point. For comparison purpose, we also have equals method. Equals method is a predefined method defined in object class. Its implementation, every method has implementation logic, no? Its logic is comparing two objects by using reference. Okay. Next, fourth point. If we call A1 dot equals of A2, first JVM search for equals method in class A. If available, it is executed from which class? It is executed from which class? Class A. And compares objects by using, tell me, reference or data, no? By using data. If not available in class A, it is executed from class object, and then two objects are compared by using reference. In string class and in all wrapper classes, equals method is overridden to compare the two objects, to compare the two string objects and two wrapper class objects by using their data. Can I use the word state? Data or state, both are same. Data is a non-technical word. State is the technical word. Okay, na? Next, sixth point. In a string buffer and in a string builder classes, equals method is not overridden, so their objects are compared by using their references. Samajh mein aaya idhar? At least now all you understand? Tell me now, seventh point. If you want to compare two objects by using reference, we must use double equal to operator. Next, eighth point. If you want to compare two objects by using data or state or content, any word can be used. We must use equals method, but no guarantee. spelling I forgot guarantee correct guarantee na spelling spelling guarantee you also don't know guarantee spelling very good guarantee na okay but no guarantee because it is depending on its implementation logic okay at least now all the people understand after typing all points 9th point we also have okay for comparing objects by using data we also have another method what that method equals ignore case but it is defined in string class but not in where object class hence we can call this method only by using string class object if we call this method by using our class object we will get we will get compiled error adi matter and this is the program please take screenshot one second एक मिनट नाउ टेक स्क्रीनशॉट डू हैव पेशेंस टू कंटिन्यू वी हैव सम मोर पॉइंट्स टू डिस्कस If your mind able to receive these points, I am ready to take you to the next points. What the 10th point we discussed? String objects and wrapper class objects comes under pooling. If we try to create two string objects or two wrapper class objects by using same literal only one object is created then double equal to operator and equals method returns true Right, based on this point, I want you to test. Look at here. I created integer object here. IO3, IO4. Please try to take decision and tell me. I have created here two integer objects by using new keyword. So their references are different. Double equal to operator return false. Equals method compares data because equals method overridden in integer class. So what the output you will get? True. False true. Everyone understand? Integer is a wrapper class. Now, I am taking here. Let me take here 5, 5. Okay, I'm taking here 5. IO5, IO6. Now tell me, here what is the output you will get? I am trying to create two integer object with literal directly. If I create objects with literal directly, two objects created? No. IO5 pointing to one object, IO6 also pointing to the same previous object, new object not created. So what will you get now here? Reference is same, true. Equals method compare data, same. Control 1 compile, control 2 will get true, true. Hello, samajh mein aaya? Now the twist point. This wrapper class object pooling is applied to only byte range values. Wrapper class objects pooling is applied only for byte range values. What did you understand? If the taken literal is in the range of byte, then only pooling will come. 150 is in the range of byte. Byte range is -128 to 127. It is not in the range of byte. So here one new object created. Here also another new object is created. False will come with a double equal to operator. What about equals? False or true? Double equal to operator, false. Equals method, true. Because equals method is overridden in integer class to compare state of the object. You will get false, true. Right? Control 1. Control 2. We'll get false, true. Everyone comfortable? So you must write that point here. What is the 11th point? String of all string literals comes under pooling. But wrapper class objects comes under pooling only if the value, the assigned value, I mean assigned literal, is in the range of byte -128 to 127. Okay, all these points you will understand in the wrapper classes chapter again. Okay, all these points will be covered in the wrapper classes chapter again. But here we should know because comparison came, you have to learn here in wrapper classes. Again, you will get revision. You may ask me questions, sir, why only byte range? Why not other range? Because Sun Microsystem has given a statement that what they observed, pooling is meant for decreasing number of repeated objects creation. So what they have observed, repeated objects, repeated integer objects, repeated number objects you create only for byte range. Within the byte range only repeated objects they found. That's why pooling they have implemented. Pooling really benefit or problem, okay, that and all we'll discuss in the string chapter and the wrapper classes chapter. At this minute, I don't want to go that much deep. Okay, these are the 11 most important points for double equal to operator and equals method. Still one more point is there, but up to here, already comfortable. Please read once again. Double equal to operator is used for comparing two primitive values or two objects. Double equal to operator compare two primitive variables by using their values. It compare two objects by using their reference. We also have predefined method equals method for comparing two objects. Equals method is a predefined method defined in object class. Its logic is comparing two objects by using reference. Many people are feeling that equals method meant for comparing objects by using data. Equals method compare two objects using data. That is wrong statement. Equals method compare two objects by default by using reference only. If you want to compare two objects by using data of the object, you must override that method in your class. If you call a1 dot equals of a2, first JVM search for equals method in class A. If available, it executed from class A and compares objects by using data. If not available in class A, means if not overridden, it is executed from class object, then two objects are compared by using reference. The most danger point in string class and in role wrapper classes, equals method is overridden to compare two objects by or to compare two string objects or two wrapper class objects by using their state. If you take any website or if you take any YouTube channels or textbooks, equals method is explained, equals method comparison is explained by using string class, and they come to a conclusion that equals method you compare two objects by using data. Which objects? String class objects are compared by using data, but not our class objects. If you want to compare your student class or employee class objects also by using data, you must override. Sir, how to override? That's a horrible story. You cannot understand. No, coming classes I'll explain. Okay, now in coming classes I'll explain. Don't worry. If you want to compare two objects by using reference, we must use double equal to operator. If you want to compare two objects by using data, we must use equals method. But no guarantee, because it is depending on its implementation logic. Okay, right. For comparing objects by using data, we also have another method called equals ignore case method, but it is only work with string class. String objects and wrapper class comes under pooling, means only one object is created if you repeat the literal. Now all string literals comes under pooling, but wrapper class objects comes under pooling only if the assigned value or assigned literal is in the range of byte. Okay, now the next horrible point. Do you know literal? There is a literal called null. Null literal is there. Null comparison. Tell me, can I compare null by using double equal to operator? Can I compare null by using double equal to operator? Yes. Null comparison by using double equal to operator returns true. Null equal to true. Na? Null equal to null is it true? Very important point. Null comparison by using equals method, possible or not possible? Come on. Equals method meant for executing with objects. Equals method should execute from a class by using object. Null is not an object. Okay, null comparison by using equals method, we will get either compile time error or runtime error called null pointer exception. Null comparison by using equals method, we will get either compile time error or runtime error. What is that? Runtime error, null pointer exception. Let us try to test it. This is the last horrible point, sir. Please concentrate. If you don't understand now, no need to worry. Again, I'll explain the coming chapters. In java.lang.object class, again, I'll explain all these points. Okay. One more time I will repeat there, but at this stage also you should understand. That time it will become repetition. Okay, fast you can catch. It will be a revision that time. Tell me, null double equal to null I have written. Any compile time error? No compile time error. Okay, there is no compile time error. both are literals. Literals you can compare. Compile successfully, executed. We are getting true. And tell me, can I use a null dot equals of null? Huh, come on, try to think what the meaning of the statement. Search for equals method in null. Dot means in, na? Search for equals method definition in null. Hey, null is of which class? No class. So compiler is confused. Are in which class I should search for equals method, Rabbi? It's not possible. So it is throwing compile time error. Look at there. Null cannot be dereferenced. It is the compile time error. You cannot call equals method by using null. Next. Now I am trying to compare null with string, double quotes A. Double quotes A equal to null. Tell me, is a double quotes A is equal to null? No, it is an object, has one reference. Null is different. So what it returns? True or false? It returns true or false? False. Because there are two different values, right? Two different values, you will get false. Null comparison with null returns true. Null comparison with object returns what? False. Tell me. Now I am trying to compare double quotes A equals of null. Here, tell me. Will you get any compile time error? No. Because you are calling equals method by using what? Double quotes A. Double quotes A is what? String. In a string class, equals method is available, and comparing string A equal to null? No. Will get what? False. Here also will get output false. False, false. So finally try to answer. You can compare two nulls by using double equal to operator, but you cannot compare by using equals method. Next, you can compare object using null, possible, false. Object and null using equals method, possible, also will get false. Next, tell me now, can I, like a string object, I'm taking my own class object. What is our own class? A1. Our own class, we created A1 object, A1. Tell me, A1 reference is something like 10, 10. 10, 10 equal to null? False. 10, 10 equal to false? False. 10, 10 equals of null? False. So you'll get false, false. Am I going fast? Did you understand this point? Null comparison by using double equal to operator 10 tools. Null comparison by using equals method will returns compile time error or null pointer exception. Now look at here. Null comparison with object returns false in both cases. All these points you need to remember. Okay. Now I'm going to ask you one more question. Please try to think. I'm creating something like this. A3 equal to null I have written. Is it an object reference variable or null referenced variable? Is it object referenced variable or null referenced variable? It is a null referenced variable. Means it contains null, na? I'm teaching Core Java faculty. Okay? There is a student called Mr. Vivek. Okay? Vivek, can you please unmute once? Vivek, unmute. Vivek, please unmute and start your webcam also. Vivek, I'm giving you final call again. Unmute and start webcam.
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. Try to speak.
Yes, sir. Good evening, sir.
Try to speak, Nana. From where you are?
Good evening, sir.
Speak loudly. I'm unable to hear. We are unable to hear. Speak loudly. Why you wanted to start webcam every every 15 minutes to 20 minutes? You wanted to show all the flowers around you. Daily one background you will start. And then you wanted to show your background, how you are expert in a Zoom software operating. Is anybody interested? Don't you feel it is a disturbance to the people who are listening the class? Why you wanted to start webcam every 15-20 minutes once? Come on, speak. What is your intention, Anna? Huh? Are you conscious? Are you conscious? Are you in the classroom? Reply. Chat in chat message, reply. If you are unable to speak, reply in chat. If you don't want to speak, you try to reply. Tell me, what is your problem? What you wanted to do? Tell me. I'm getting complaint from you. You are not only in this class doing this work. In every class, you are doing the same story. Why? What is your intention? You are very good sitting correctly and listening correctly. Wonderful. Why you want to behave like bad way? What is your intention? Why you want to disturb? Class is going in a good mood. Suddenly you started webcam. And background all the were, you know, flowers. Something going backside, like, you know, Ravanji and, you know, Rajmouli movie. Do you want to become director? Or you want to become Java developer? I want to talk to you every day, but, you know, I am in a good mood of subject, so I don't want to disturb my flow. That's a bad attitude, Nana. Really, really bad. So nobody is interested to know about your face. Nobody interested to know about your talent in the Zoom, how to add the background in the Zoom. Nobody interested to know. All are very serious about the subject. Please don't repeat it. So you are very sincere. That's why I'm talking. If otherwise, I would remove you silently background, okay? Without you, your information also, you can remove it from here. I have everything control. Because you are very sincere, listening properly, sitting properly, listening. But only small, you know, bad thing you are doing. Please try to correct that mistake, okay? Don't start webcam. If you want to play with the webcam saying that, you know, my image is properly coming or not, if you wanted to see, just create one free account in Zoom software and you can try everything. Vivek, reply. Okay, na? Are you listening? Is it okay? Whatever I'm talking, is it good? Okay, because of you, 5 minutes time wasted, right? In these 5 minutes, we can discuss next points. See how many more points are there to discuss. So don't do that mistake, okay? Because of me, or because of you, because of we, other people should not get disturbance in the class. That is what correct behavior. Now, once mind is deviated, again bring that mind back to the flow. My God. Println of A3 double equal to null. Will you get a true or false? Just apply common sense and tell me. Come on, I have written A3 equal to null, system dot out dot println, A3 double equal to null, I have written. Tell me. what is the A3 value? Null. Right? And comparing with what? Null. So what will happen? You will get true. Null equal to equal to true. So I hope your mind slowly connected to the points, right? Then next, A3, I'm writing dot equals of A3 dot equals of null. Bolo, what happened now? Any compile time error? No compile time error here. Compiler found equals method in A class or in super A class. No compile time error. But at runtime, equals method must execute with the data available in A3 variable. A3 variable object is object or null? Null. Listen, if you are invoking a method by using null referenced variable, you will get null pointer exception. You will get null pointer exception. You cannot invoke a method by using null or by using null reference variable. If invoke by using null, you will get compile time error. If you invoke by using null referenced variable, you will get exception. Okay, here you will get compile time error, here you will get exception. Rabuji, can you please practice and remember it? Slowly you will understand at this statement, at this minute. I have to teach, I am teaching. Either you understand or not understand, least bother. All these points will come again in volume 2. In volume 2 in object class, all these points once again will come. The time more subject maturity is there, you will understand everything. At this minute, just you practice and by heart remember. Okay, nah? If you compare object by using, if you call method by using null, compiler throw error. If you call method by using null referenced variable, get runtime error. Is it clear? Next, last point, okay? Last point. Tell me, is this line compiled? System.out@println. Double quote say double equal to 10. Hey, can you compare Hare Krishna with a fan? Can you compare Hare Krishna with a lion, tiger? Bad operand types for binary operator. What is that? String, comma, int. Danger point. Listen, danger point. Same statement I am writing like this. In place of double equal, I am writing equals method. Bolo? Will you get any incompatible types compile time error? No. No compile time error. Compiled successfully, executed successfully, will get output false. Okay, na? Equals method is a method, it's not an operator, it is a method. So it will take the two values and logic executed background, both references are different. So it's compare and return false. Now final conclusion, can you tell me? I want you prepare a table, difference between double equal to operator, difference between double equal to operator and equals method. Generally people call it as a dot equals method. It is not dot equals method, equals. Double equal to operator and equals method, that's it. Don't pronounce as a dot equals, equals. Now tell me, what are the points you discussed, difference between double equal and equals, tell me. Point number one. Totally, I taught you 4 points. Totally 4 points I taught you. Please try to recollect all 4 points. First point is what? It is used for comparing both primitive data types and objects. Whereas equals method, it can be used only for comparing objects. Point number one, right? Point number two. It compares two objects by using reference always. Most important. Bolo. Some people are having wrong thought. Please try to recollect. people writing, right? It is meant for comparing two objects by using data. Yes. Okay, it meant for comparing two objects by using data, but it never compared by default, it never compares. So it compares two objects either by using reference or by using data, depending on its implementation logic. Must write point by default. It also compares two objects by using reference. Next, for comparing two objects by using reference, we must use double equal to operator. For comparing two objects by using data, we must use equals method, comma, we must override it in our class. Okay. Fourth point. What the fourth point? We can compare two nulls, comma, returns true. We cannot compare two nulls. Either we'll get next. We cannot compare incompatible objects. We will get compiled error. Next, we can compare incompatible objects. We will get false bracket because different reference or different type, either because of different reference or because of different type. So these are the five points you must talk to interviewer. You know, if interviewer asked a question, can you tell me the differences between double equal to operator and equals method? Immediately you will get smile on your face. Okay. In your examination, your university examination, when you see a known question, okay, when you see a known question, immediately you will get smile face. Nah? Yes, I know all questions. Then you are getting ready to start writing answer, na? Same thing. If interviewer ask a question, tell difference between double equal to operator and equals method, immediately you should smile. I know. We did almost 2 hours discussion on this topic with the different test cases. Today you must remind in your interview room. So we completed half of the points about OCA bits. We have still 1 or 2 points are there that we'll discuss in tomorrow class. I hope you'll practice all these points today and come tomorrow. What do you say? Please take third page. Third, fourth page, take screenshot.